best tool to tame inflation, interest rates or price controls. Inflation is at a four-decade high. The world's central banks have just committed to intervention. However, experts argue that a major element pushing rising prices is being overlooked, a surge in corporate profits. Non-financial profit margins in the United States in 2021 reached levels not seen since the end of World War II. Nonetheless, the Federal Reserve appears to feel that removing monetary stimulus and raising interest rates is the best way to battle inflation. However, some economists feel that profiteering and the supply chain crisis are at the root of the problem. These economists advocate for a serious discussion of strategic price controls, like those employed after World War II. Today's economists seemingly are divided into two camps on the topic of inflation. One group believes that inflation is only temporary and that we need not be concerned about it since it will soon disappear. Another group believes that inflation is more permanent. They argue for fiscal restraint, no new government spending, as well as higher interest rates. Now, a third group of economists has emerged, those who argue that instead of contractionary fiscal and monetary policies that advance austerity, the government should target the exact prices in the exact industries that most greatly contribute to inflation. The best historical comparison for today's inflation, according to the White House Council of Economic Advisers, is the aftermath of World War II. Due to substantial household savings, there was pent-up demand, such as now currently exists. This was the effect of increased earnings and rationing during World War II, and currently is the outcome of stimulus checks and shutdowns under COVID-19. Supply chains were interrupted in both cases. Unlike now, however, the White House previously advocated for targeted price limits in industries that contribute the most to inflation. This strategy was backed by many economists. They claimed that price limits for vital items should be maintained as long as bottlenecks prevented supply from meeting demand. This would prevent prices from skyrocketing and unjustly enriching corporate profits. Today, the option of permitting the continual rise of prices that drives up profits or tailoring controls on carefully selected prices is once again available. Price limits would buy time to deal with bottlenecks that will persist as long as the pandemic persists. Advocates also note that tighter monetary policy and higher interest rates will not resolve supply chain issues. They additionally feel the resulting austerity would make matters worse, increasing the likelihood of stagflation. Instead of assuming there is no alternative to contractionary fiscal and monetary policy, proponents advocate for a systematic consideration of strategic price controls as a weapon in the larger policy response to the massive macroeconomic difficulties we confront today. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. It helps others find our content.